Yeah. Welcome to operating system class. In our earlier discussion, we were talking about the structure of a page table, a conventional page table, which maps the relationship associated between the logical address space to the physical address space. So in between that, we have a page table, and it is maintained by the memory management unit of the operating system. And it is going to convert the pages with the pages. Was the first illustration. And the second way of representing a structural approach of paging was the hierarchical item, where it is going to have some outer page table, and thereby it maps to the inner page table, and finally it maps to the displacement, and thereby it is going to get the contents in the memory. So this was the second way of representing a page table. Now, in this today's class, we will be discussing about the remaining two ways of representing the. The first one will be the hashing approach, and other one will be the inverted page table. First one will be the hashing page table, and another will be the inverted page table. That we will have a quick in this class. We talked about shared pages. Then we talked about hierarchy pages. We implemented outer, inner, and displacement pointing out to the memory. After that, we have a new way of structuring the page table. That is what we are going to call it as hashed page table. After the two-level representation of a page table, now we are going to focus on the hashed page tables. So, what will be the importance of representing a hashed page table? The importance was, if the address space is greater than 32 bit, that is 2^32, at that point, it will be some 1 million pages of 1 KB. It will be very difficult to handle by the CPU to generate the logical address space. So at that time, this virtualization takes up the support of hashing. So the only solution was to generate a hash key, to generate a hash code, and thereby build up a page table. The reason was the address space need to be having a scope, too much scope. So if I'm going to say 2^32, so a lot of page space is going to have a virtualization at the CPU end, which may not be feasible. So for that, they are going to believe with another page table concept called as hashing. Fine. Now, what does this hashing do? That means the first and foremost item was it is going to use a search mechanism. It is going to do a search mechanism. The searching mechanism is not new to us. We have worked on cache memory, that is the translation lookaside buffers. The item is found in the TLB, we said it as TLB hit. And if it is not found in that, then we say it is TLB miss, and we worked out in the page table and we reiterated this process. So then brought up the pages from the secondary memory, that is where the frames are going to be illustrated, and updated with the page table, and thereby update it with the TLBs. And TLB, if it is having an empty space, it used to get that page. If it is not empty, then it is going to use up some memory management algorithms and replace the existing between the page table, which is in the memory, main memory, and with the TLBs. So that is what happened earlier. More or less, hashing does the same aspect. More or less, hashing does a same aspect. And of course, hashing, it is going to be used as a search mechanism. Hashing is going to be used for a search mechanism. So in this hashing, it is going to generate a hash code for the page. It is going to generate a hash code for the page. And second thing, it is going to be represented in a way of linked list. It is going to be represented in a way of linked list. So let us take up these three items. See here. So the virtual page number is going to be hashed into a page table. And second thing, it is going to form as a chain. And how we are going to represent the elements in a hashing? Yeah, first one, it is going to take up the virtual page number. Second thing, it is going to check up to which frame it is going to be mapped. And third item, it is going to have a pointer to the next item. So first one, hash code is going to be generated to the page. That is item number one. Item number two, it is going to link up to the frame in physical address space. So hash code for a page, it is going to be in virtual, or I can say logical address space. And the third thing, it is going to have a linked list to point out to the next item. So using these three strategies of working principle, the hashing is going to be accepted. Does such mechanism going to organize a page table, and every entity in a page table, it is going to have one, it is the virtual page is going to be hashed. Two, it is going to be mapped to frame. Item going to be with pointers, with linked list pointers, and all of them, they are going to form as a chain. At this point, the hash function is going to be applied and a hash code is going to be obtained. And the displacement, what we are going to take up, is going to be common in both. So there is no deviation at the displacement, because whether I'm going to use it in a logical, whether I'm going to use a two-way hierarchical item, nor a pure page table, nor an inverted index page table, whatever concept we take up, the size of a page is equals to size of a frame. That is the thumb rule, right? The size of a page is equal to size of the frame. So obviously, if the displacement is 50 at the logical address space, the same 50 can be forwarded to the physical address space, because there is no change in the size. So that is the advantage what this displacement or what this offset is going to get. So now we are going to talk about this hashed page table here. So in this hashed page table, the CPU is going to rise up this logical address, and this logical address is going to constitute of page, and it is going to have D as displacement, or we are going to call it as an offset. So this is going to be moved towards physical, where we are going to have this physical memory, and now page table is going to have a hashing structure. Page table is going to have the hashing structure. How is this structure happened? It is going to have hash function. It is going to have a hash function, and this hash function, it is going to use exclusively for searching, and it should be exclusively very fast, very fast. So what are the three items I was just telling in maintaining the hash page table? First one, page is going to have hashed function. Second one, frame is mapped. Third thing, it is organized as a linked list chain, and it is going to be sequenced with one after the other. So you do have page and you do have frame. So page and frame, and it is going to be in form of a chain, and it is going to be pointing out to the physical address. It is going to be pointed to the physical address. So keep cracking recap here. So every element of a hash page, it is going to have a virtual page number, which is generated with a hash code. Second thing, the value what is going to rise up, it is going to be mapped with the frame. Third thing, a pointer towards the next element is going to be taken up. So at this point, we have a value here. We have a value, and that value is going to be linked to this direction with R here. So hash function generates hash value. Hash function, it is going to generate hash value for P, that is page. Fine. I was mentioning hash page table, it is going to be used for searching. It is used for searching. And search is to be successful. When a search is going to be successful, if the item what it is going to be given hash function is available with the hash, then we are going to test successful. If it is not available, then we are going to call it as unsuccessful. What is available? So here we can see that a page number is going to be compared in the chain, and a search is going to be mapped, and whatever match is going to be performed, the corresponding physical frame is going to be extracted. If the physical frame is going to be extracted, then we can say search is successful. That is physical frame is extracted. That means I do have a page, it moves to the hash function, then it is going to be pointed out to the hash table, and corresponding page is going to have a hash value, and a frame is going to be taken up, and a chain is going to be raised, and it is going to give a value, and if that value is going to be mapped to this physical address space, if it is going to be found, yes, we can say data is going to be extracted. Data is going to be extracted. Otherwise, it is not going to be considered. So we can say the search is not going to be successful. Fine. After the hashing is going to happen, the another way of representing the structure of a page table will be the inverted page table. Inverted page table. Either in the conventional page table, nor the translation look aside buffer page table, nor two level page table, nor hashing page table, we are going to represent all entries of each process. We are representing all entries of each process in form of pages, that is with page table base register towards page table limit register. Everything we are going to write it. Now, what does this inverted page table is going to suggest us? Instead of giving a complete, instead of displaying complete page table, mark, or you can say collect only the page table base register and collect the process IDs, collect the process IDs, and thereby make a pairing mechanism between the process ID and the page, and then you mark it towards the frame. As simple as such, right? Instead of putting entire page table in the space, instead of putting the entire page table into the page table space, just pick up only the starting address of the page. Only the starting address of the page. And you name it as some process ID or a page ID. You name it as a page ID. And don't go for physical address space. Don't go for the virtual or logical address space. Use the real address or use the physical address during the tabulation of page table. So during construction of a page table, don't go for virtual addresses. Rather than use the same physical addresses in the page table entry. But how do I distinguish whether it is a virtual address, nor how do I distinguish whether it is a real address? That was the scenario. To do that, it is going to propose a mechanism called as pairing aspect with page ID and the page. So how is this going to be implemented? We do have an inverted page table architecture, and the logical address space, they are going to be used by the CPU. The physical address space, they are going to be done with the random access memory or the physical memory here. And you do have a page ID followed by the page, and we are going to make a searching mechanism. So page ID, comma page, we make it as a pair here. So we unify the PID and we unify the P to get this inverted index, to get the inverted index, and that inverted index you are going to write it as an I. Of course, either at a logical address space, either at a physical address space, the displacement is same. That's the reason why we are not talking about displacement and directly adding the displacement either at a source end or at a destination end. So the inverted page table or a hashing or a two-level structure, all of those, they search for an item. And if an item is going to be available, it is going to be extracted there itself. And a hit was successful. If the item was not successful, there is an indication that the item was not available in a page table and it should be upgraded. That means the data has to be brought from the physical memory and to be upgraded into the page table. And a mapping procedure should happen between pages and frames. So that all scenario has to be taken place here. So why we are going to have inverted page table? Because the memory scope was too big. It can be 2 power 32, or it is going to be some 2 power 64, the illustration goes far beyond the CPU's expectation, and CPU doesn't have that much of internal capacity of a memory chip. So that is the reason why this inverted page table is coming into picture. And it, rather than storing the entire page table for each process, it is going to take up the page table starting address, and it is going to keep all the tracks of the all the available logical pages, and it is going to mingle with all the available physical pages also. Second thing, it is going to deploy one entry. It is going to deploy only one entry for a real page. That means it is going to make page table base register for each process. For each process, it is going to hold only the page table base register there. So it is going to contain the address of a page stored in the real memory and the information about the process, who is going to own it. That means how it is going to own it. It is going to have some process ID followed by the page. It is going to be a pair. Thereby, it is going to have a displacement. And this entire space, it is going to point out to the real page addresses. So the illustration of a inverted page is going to be given here. The CPU, it is going to process to the process ID with P, and it is going to search it in the page table, and information is going to be extracted. If it is going to be extracted, then we are going to call it as successful, and not extracted, then we are going to call it as unsuccessful. Then we are going to call it as unsuccessful. Yeah. So in today's class, we had a quick recap of all the four items, thereby items of paging structure. That was one. It was hierarchical, two hashed, and third one was inverted index. So hierarchical, it is meeting two level page structure, and the page is going to have 12, 10, and 10. And the mapping was between frames and with pages. And obviously the drawback was if it is greater than 2 power 32, it is a little bit difficult and clumsy to maintain in this ways. So a hash code is going to be generated with the hash page tables, and it is going to store up the virtual page. It is going to store up what the mapped frame to it and the pointers of the next elements. So it is going to generate a chain, and thereby it is going to get a hash value. Based on that hash value, the item is going to be found at the physical space. So that is hashed index happened. So the another solution when the memory was vast was, instead of using hash code, instead of using hash value, there is an inverted page table. Either in any of a technique of the structured way, that conventional followed by TLBs followed by two level and followed by hashing, everything is going to maintain a process. Every process has a page table, and that page table may have n number of pages. So for all those entities are going to be recorded. So that is a little bit way of occupying memory. So the solution was, it was being proposed with an inverted page table. So inverted page table, it is going to point out the page table base register, and it is going to hold only the process information, and it is going to hold only the process location, process table base register, and rest it is not going to be stored. When it is going to have a process ID, the entire process is going to be taken up with the process control block, with the process ID tracks, what is the total size, what is the limit register, where it is going to occupy, how many frames it is going to happen, it is going to be stored. So entire information is going to be in the process ID. So how is this inverted index is going to be maintained? Was in the logical address space itself, the process ID is taken up, the P is going to be the page, and both of them, they are going to be as a pair, and they are going to be searched. And if the search was in the page table, it is going to be extracted. If it is not available, then we say the content cannot be extracted, and it has to be dumped from the physical memory, and then it has to be deployed it with the page table. So if it is going to be successful, the process ID and P, they are going to be paid, and an inverted index is going to be raised here. And based on that inverted index, the associated frame is going to be mapped. So that is how a inverted page table is going to be organized. Yeah, this is all for today's class. Thank you for joining.